डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम वी एन गवांदे, लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेली कम्युनिकेशन एट के वाक पॉलिटेक्निक नासिक. टूडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द एरर्स. इट इज़ अ इम्पॉर्टेंट परफॉर्मेंस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ एनी मेजरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट. वी हैव टू लर्न दिस एरर्स अंडर द सब्जेक्ट Electronics, Measurements and Instrumentation for EJ and Electronics branches. Now, what is the errors? Before that errors, why, where the errors are occurring? The errors are occurring due to the measuring process when we are measuring some physical quantities or electrical quantities. And before looking into these errors, we will see first what is the measurement. According to the definition, measurement is the process of comparing unknown quantity with an acceptable standard quantity. It involves connecting a measuring instrument into system under consideration and observing the resulting response on the instrument. As shown here, two meters. One is the multimeter and second is the panel meter, which measuring the voltages, and one is measuring the value of resistance. In the measurement, there is a very important There should be a predetermined value, and we call it as a true value or expected values. That is, the measurement thus obtained is a quantitative measure of the so-called true value. It is also called expected value. Now see the important thing related to errors is the definition of error. The deviation of the true value from the desired value. Deviation means the difference. That is the difference between true value and expected value. Now look at it. The other definition. The degree to which an instrument measurement nears the expected value. It is expressed in terms of the error of measurements. Error may be expressed either as absolute or as a percentage of error. Absolute error is defined as the difference between the expected value of the variable and the measured value of the variable. That is just a numerical difference. As per the formula, E is equals to YN minus XN, where A is the absolute error, YN is the expected value, Xn is the measured value. Then percentage error is given by this formula: absolute value divided by expected value into 100. That is E divided by Yn into 100. Therefore, in bracket, Yn minus Xn divided by Yn into 100. This percentage error is frequently expressed as accuracy rather than error. That is, capital A is the modulus of Yn minus Xn divided by Yn. That is E divided by Yn. E is the absolute error. In above formula, A is the relative accuracy. So, accuracy is expressed as percentage accuracy. Small a is equals to 100% minus percentage error. That is, A is equals to capital A into 100%, where small a is the percentage accuracy. Now we'll see the errors. There are two types of errors: static errors and dynamic errors. The static errors means they are occurring due to some slow changes in the time. That is the static. And dynamics means they are these errors occurring when there is a change in the time span. Now, there are three different types of static errors: gross error, systematic errors, and random errors. Systematic errors are again classified as instrumental errors, environmental errors, and observational errors. Now look first the gross errors. Now the word gross means bulk or lot of, and everybody knows the contributors for the errors are the humans. That is why the gross errors are mainly due to human mistakes. In reading or in using instruments or errors in recording the observations. All these cases are related to the human systems and their mistakes. Errors may also occur due to incorrect adjustment of instruments and computational mistakes or while calculating the values. These gross errors may not be treated mathematically. The complete elimination of gross errors is not possible, but one can minimize them. Some errors are easily detected, while others may be elusive. जब तक ह्यूमन बेइंग्स है तब तक एरर जाने वाली नहीं है. वन ऑफ द बेसिक ग्रॉस एरर्स दैट ऑकर्स फ्रिक्वेंटली इज द इम्प्रॉपर यूज ऑफ एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट. यस, इट इज ट्रू, इम्प्रॉपर यूज ऑफ एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट मीन्स चेंज ऑफ द एरर in terms of the scale changes of the instrument, there may be error. Instead of measuring voltage by using voltmeter, some will take ammeters. Yes, it is true. And this is a basic gross error. The error can be minimized by taking proper care in reading and recording the measurement parameter. Take more one reading in different conditions each in which the instruments are switched and off. Now, systematic error. The word systematic is related to the system, that is sometimes we call device. System means these errors are related to the systems. Now, these errors occur due to shortcomings of what? Such as defective, wear and tear, aging, or effects of the environment on the instrument. instrumental errors are inherent in measuring instruments because of their mechanical structure. These errors are called instrumental errors and are inherent in measuring instruments because of their mechanical structure. Mind here. Instrumental errors are bound to be there. It is inherent property of this instrument because there is a mechanical structure. And when there is a mechanical, look at this mechanical structures. There is a movement, there is a motion, there is a rotation, there is a fluctuations, there is a suspension, changes. And so it will the instrument will produce some errors. Now, for example, in the deaccelerant movement, friction in the bearings of various moving parts, irregular spring tensions, stretching of the spring, or reduction in tension due to improper handling or overloading of the instrument. The picture shows us the moving coil galvanometer. In this case, instead of indicator or pointer, the mirror is used. Now, how to minimize instrumental errors? Very simple. Select a suitable instrument for the particular measurement applications. Applying correction factors after determining the amount of instrumental errors. Calibrating the instrument against the standard. Next, errors. Environmental errors. Now the word environment, and that affects the measurement techniques. And environmental errors are due to conditions external to the measuring device, including condition the area surrounding the instrument, such as the effects of change in temperature, humidity, barometric pressure, or of the magnetic field or electrostatic fields. And how to minimize these errors? By using air conditioning, hermetically sealing certain components in the instruments, and using magnetic fields or shields to protect the static and magnetic fields. Then third one, observational errors, instrumental errors. And now the word observational means related to the observe. Again, the human beings will come into the picture. That means these errors are occurring due to the observing and recording the errors. The most common error is the parallax error introduced in reading a meter scale and the reading of estimation when obtained a reading from the meter. Analog. In this case, shown a vertical scale. In this scale, the person who is looking from the green line will record the readings very precisely, accurately, and his axis of eye and the readings are parallel to each other, so there will be no error. But the both red lines, vertical top and bottom, will be in terms of the reading. That errors will be there. Now look at this left and right, two scales, also similar one, to show the observational errors. Now third error, that is random error. These errors that remain after gross error and systematic errors have been substantially reduced or at least accounted for. Random errors are generally an accumulation of a large number of small effects and may be of real concern only in measurements requiring a high degree of accuracy. Such errors can be analyzed statistically. We just read out the random errors. The cause of these errors are unknown. No direction, from which direction it comes. It does not depend on the observer, the system, the environment, but still they are occurring. Their cause is unknown. That is why it is called a random errors. And these random errors are treated or minimized. Everybody knows there is no chances of elimination, but we can minimize it by taking arithmetic mean, deviation from the mean, average deviation, and standard deviations. These are the statistical or mathematical means. Okay, there are some questions from the MSPT. List types of errors. What are the definitions of accuracy, precision, errors? Explain the errors. And sometimes a problem on random errors. Okay, and there is one example which shows the different types of accuracy and precision measuring devices. First voltmeter V1, second voltmeter V2, and third voltmeter V3 and V4. Recording the true value readings 150 and showing different values 4 times. The first V1 will be in high precision, V2 is in accurate, V3 not accurate and not precision, and V4 is highly accurate and highly precise instrument. Take the readings and see the readings also. Thank you.